Welcome to Swain County, and we're ready for today's baseball game between the Cherokee Braves and our own Swain County Maroon Devils. On the mound for Swain County today is number 5, Darren Blankenship. Swain County comes in today with a 2-5 record. Cherokee is 0-6. Leading things off for Cherokee is their leading hitter, shortstop Jace Waddy. Swing and a miss. And we have no scoreboard. I think it's 1-1. Leadoff batter Jace Waddy at the plate, facing Darren Blankenship. Foul down the left field line, 1-2. Jace Waddy, their leading hitter, leading off. Strike 3 is called. So Darren Blankenship strikes out the leadoff man. We've got one out and nobody on. And Luke Woodard, the second baseman at the plate now for Cherokee. Luke is Cindy Woodard's son. Swing and a miss, strike 1. Darren Blankenship looking sharp. Pitching from a stretch, even though nobody's on base. Swung on and hit down to the shortstop. Trey Bradley fields it and throws on to first for the out. Two outs, two quick outs. So two up and two down, and the opposing pitcher now, Anaya Younce, will be at the plate for Cherokee. Number 12. Usually somebody wearing number 12, that means you're a good player. They don't give the number 12 to bad players. That's good players. And he's batting a 3-hole doing the pitching, so. Takes a leadoff ball, 1-0. Two outs, nobody on. Top of the first inning, just getting started, 0-0. Swain and Cherokee. Ball 2. Darren Blankenship on the mound, looking good. Swing and a miss. Strike 1, 2-1. Foul to the right side. 2-2, count even. Deuces wild, two outs. Two balls, two strikes. Ball 3, full count. John Davis, the coach for Cherokee. And ball 4. So with two outs, the number 3 man, Younce, draws a walk. Demetrius Bradley now comes to the plate, the first baseman for Cherokee. Batting was 1-0 and 2 outs. Big left-handed batter. Demetrius. Blankenship checks the runner at first. Oh, low one. It hit him. So we got 2 on now. The first pitch hit on the foot, looked like. 2 on and 2 outs. That'll bring up Dalton Maney, the center fielder for Cherokee. Dalton Maney. My mama's maiden name was Maney. I wonder if we're related. Two on and two outs. Top of the first, no score. Darren Blankenship from the stretch, pitches, swung on, hit in the air out in center field. Center fielder comes over and he makes the catch. I think that was Smith out there making that catch. So Dalton Maney makes the third out. And after one half inning of play, we have no score. And we'll be right back with Swain coming to the plate. We'll be right back. Okay, bottom of the first inning of the scoreless ball game. Trey Bradley leading off for Swain County against Anaya Younce for Cherokee. 0-0, bottom of the first. Yes, winds and pitches. Ball one to Bradley. Swain comes in with a three-game losing streak, so it's desperate. They're desperate for a win. Next pitch is grounded foul, 1-1. Anaya Younts on the mound for Cherokee. Winds and pitches. Hit hard out in the center field. Center fielder comes over, coming over. Right fielder cuts in front and makes the catch. So Trey Bradley flies out to right, one out, and Gage Southers, the left fielder, now steps to the plate for Swain County. Trey Bradley has been our leading hitter all year long. Gage Southers coming on. He's really come on lately. He's done good. Strong defender and a good batter. Batting in a two-hole today. Takes strike one from Younts. Isaiah Armour changes the third baseman for Cherokee. Two strikes now to Southards. Swung on that on the ground to second. Second baseman fields it, throws over to first. He's out. So two quick outs for Swain. Two outs and nobody on. Ian Brooks, our catcher, comes to the plate. That's Sean Brooks' son, just a freshman, but quite a player. Anaya Younts gets a sign. Ball one to Brooks. 1-0. One ball and one strike now to Ian Brooks. Younts gets his sign. Swung on and foul back. 1-2 now. Two outs and nobody on. Bottom of the first, no score. Swain and Cherokee. Outside, ball two. Count even now at 2-2. Hit on the ground, that's a shortstop. Shortstop comes over, throws to first, and he got him. So three up and three down for the Maroon Devils in the bottom of the first. After one full inning, our score remains 0-0, and we'll be right back. Cherokee's catcher, Terrell Bernheisel, leads things off. He'll be followed by Isaiah Armachain and Jaden Welch. Number 11. No, that's Terrell Bradley leading things off. Terrell Bradley, the catcher. Bernheisel, left fielder, he'll be next. Bradley, the batter. Number 16, Terrell Bradley. Ball two, 2-0. Blankenship on the mound. He had a very impressive first inning. Let's see what he follows that up with here in the second. 2-0, swung on, foul back, 2-1. T- Terrell Bradley, the batter. Foul back again. Count even, 2-2. Top of the second inning, 0-0. Swain and Cherokee. Cherokee at bat. Darren Blankship on the mound. Winds and pitches. Ball 3. So full count to the leadoff batter, Terrell Bradley. Struck him out. So Bradley is out looking, so that'll bring up the left fielder, Tony Bernheisel, batting with one out and nobody on. Blankenship looking good on the mound. Swung on and missed. Strike one. Neil Blankenship, son Darren on the mound. Strike two is called. 0-2. Oh, ball one, just a little bit outside. Not Bob, didn't miss my much. One ball, two strikes, and one out, nobody on. Top of the second. Ball two. Swung on, hit on the ground out to second. Second baseman charges. Fields throws, and bad throw. The ball gets away. He's on his way to second. Ian Brooks backs him up. Too late. He's in safely at second on a error all the way. A good throw would have got him, but it was a bad throw, and it got away, and he got all the way to second base. That'll bring up number 20, Isaiah Armachain, Cherokee's third baseman today. Man on second and one out. Blankenship from the stretch. Swing and a miss, strike one to Armachain. Dawson Chambers is hit hard out towards second in the right field. It's a base hit. The runner comes to third, and he stops right there. First and third. Good, clean base hit by Armachain. First and third and one out. That'll bring up the number 9 hitter, right fielder Jaden Welch for Cherokee. We need to get this guy without the run scoring. One out, first and third. No score. Darren Blankenship on the mound from the stretch. Low, ball one. To Jaden Welch, number 8. Blankenship from the stretch. Swing and a miss. Strike one. 1-1. One out. 0-0. From the stretch, Blankenship pitches. Strike two is called. That goes runner to second, and he's standing. No throw. Uncontested. Second and third now, still just one out. Blankenship still from the stretch, pitching outside, ball two. Count even at 2-2. Bernheis on at third. Isaiah Armachain at second. Swing and a miss, he struck him out. That was a big out by Blankenship. He rode back and threw that fastball in there and got him out. Look at swinging. Two outs now, still second and third. And the top of the batting order, Jace Waddy comes to bat. We got an open base at first, and he is their best hitter. So what are you going to do? You're going to pitch to him, you're going to walk him? I think you're going to pitch to him. Ball one outside. Sometimes in a situation like this, you might get an unintentional walk. They might pitch around him, not give him anything good to hit. If he wants to swing at a bad pitch, let him swing at a bad pitch. 1-0, swung on. He's hitting the air out to right field. Michael Laws coming over and makes the catch. Michael Laws makes the catch in right field. That retires the side. So Cherokee squanders a good scoring opportunity as Waddy flies out to right. And after 1.5 innings, our score remains 0-0, and we'll be right back. Jordan McGahey leading things off here in the bottom of the second inning of a scoreless ball game. Swain and Cherokee. Anaya Younts still on the mound for Cherokee. Bottom of the second, no score. Big first baseman. McGahey leading things off for Swain. First pitch is high, ball one. Anaya Younts looks pretty poised out there on the mound right now for Cherokee. We need to get our hitting shoes on. 1-0 to count to McGahey, leading things off in the top of the bottom of the second. Outside, ball two. Two-0 pitch is high, ball three. So Younts struggling just a tad with his control, falling behind 3-0 to the leadoff batter. Don't want to walk the leadoff batter. Strike one is called to Jordan McGahey. Three and one's the count. Swing and a miss, strike two. So after falling behind 3-0, and now Younts fights back to make it full, 3-2. Jordan McGahey stepping back in. Anaya Younts from the stretch with nobody on. Ball four is low. So Jordan McGahey draws a leadoff walk. That'll bring up Michael Laws to the plate. Right fielder made that good catch out there to end the last inning with the runners on. Michael has home run power. Leads the team in RBIs. I think he's got 10 on the year, which is, I think, second in the conference. High, ball one. Jordan McGahey on it first. Michael Laws at the plate. Nobody out. Bottom of the second, no score. Anaya Younts checks the runner at first. Hey, ball gets away, ball two. McGahey's on his way to second. He's standing at second base on a pass ball, looks like. Catcher probably should have had that one. 2-0 to count to Michael Laws. Jordan McGahey in scoring position at second base. Younts from the stretch, checks the runner. Swung on, hit in the air out towards center fielder. Center fielder going back. He makes the catch. And McGahey stays put at second. So Michael Laws flies out for the first out. And that'll bring up Craig Cutshaw, today's designated hitter. Craig Cutshaw at the plate, one out and one on. Anaya Younts on the mound from the stretch, checks the runner at second. That's McGahey, way high on the outside, ball one to Cutshaw. One and oh, Younts checks the runner. Ball gets away, it's ball two, and McGahey's on his way to third, and he's standing at third base now with just one out on two pass balls. 2-0 the count to Craig Cutshaw. Run on third and no score. Bottom of the second. Swain and Cherokee. Anaya Younts still from the stretch. Strike one is called to Craig Cutshaw. Looked like right down the middle of fastball. I think he was taken all the way. Younts has struggled a little bit with his control this inning. 2-1 to count. Swing on foul back. 2-2. Jordan McGahey on at third. Craig Cutshaw at the plate. A nigh ounce from the stretch, pitches, swung, and foul back. Count holds it, 2-2. One out, one on. Swain County trying to break this scoreless tie in the bottom of the second, runner on third. Foul back. Count holds at 2-2. Craig Cutshaw, Rick Cutshaw's son at the plate. Swinging from the left side of the plate. Big left-handed hitter. A 9 ounce from the stretch. Checks the runner. Pitches. Swung and a miss. He struck him out. So Craig Cutshaw cannot get the run in. That'll bring up number three. That's Dawson Chambers playing third base today. Dawson Chambers did some pitching the other day against Rosman. Did pretty good. Need a good two-out RBI right now. Strike one is called to Dawson. Jordan McGahat takes a short lead at third. Ball one. 1-1. Two outs. Clutch situation for Dawson Chambers trying to break a scoreless tie in the bottom of the second. Strike two is called. So Dawson Chambers now looking for his pitch, trying to put one in play. Younce on the mounds from the stretch. Checks the runner at third. Swung on hit. Out toward shortstop in the left field. No, he's safe at first. Safe at first, the run scores. The shortstop made the stop. That was a fantastic stop with the shortstop, but he was late on the throw to first, and McGahat scored from third. That'll bring up Daniel Ammons. Daniel Ammons, the batter for Swain High. Ammons playing second base today. Two balls and no strikes. We got a runner on it first and two outs. 1-0, Swain County on top. Quick throw over, but he's back safely. Yeah, showed a pretty good move right there. Yes, checks the runner once again at first. Pitches to Ammons. Strike call. 2-1. Swung on, foul back. Two balls, two strikes, and two outs. One on at first base. 1-0. Swain County on top. Bottom of the second. A nigh ounce on the mound for Cherokee. Checks the runner. Swung on. Hit towards short. Waddy fields it, throws to second for the force out. And that will retire the side. After two innings of play, our score now is Swain County 1, Cherokee 0. We'll be right back. Top of the third inning, Swain County on top, 1-0. Due up this time for Cherokee will be Luke Woodard, Anaya Younce, and Demetrius Bradley. Luke Woodard leading things off. Playing second base for Cherokee today. Takes ball one from Darren Blankenship, who's pitched two scoreless innings so far and looked pretty sharp. Strike, swing and a miss. One ball, one strike to Luke Woodard. Luke Woodard is Ray Clure's grandson. Anybody know Ray Clure? Ball two to Luke. 2-1. Yance, or Darren Blankenship pitches. Ball three. 3-1 to count. Luke Woodard leading things off here on top of the third inning. Swing count out on top of Cherokee, 1-0. Outside, ball four. So Luke Woodard draws a leadoff walk. That'll bring up the opposing pitcher, Anaya Yance. You don't like to walk those leadoff batters. They usually come back to bite you. Anaya Yance, the pitcher for Cherokee at the plate. Darren Blankenship from the stretch checks the runner at first. That's Woodard over there. Strike one is called. 0-1 to Anaya Yance. Darren Blankenship checks the runner from the stretch. Swung on, hit hard out toward left field. It's in there for a hit. Gage Southern fumbling around, but he comes up with it and throws it back in. Runners hold it first and second. Anaya Yance, a solid base hit to left field. They'll bring up Demetrius Bradley, first baseman for Cherokee. Big left-handed batter. Two on and nobody out. Top of the third inning. Swing count on top of Cherokee, 1-0. Darren Blankenship from the stretch checks his runners. Swung on. Hit in the air out toward right field. That's Michael Law settling under. Makes the catch. Woodard tagging it second, and he goes sliding into third base safely. So the Woodard alertly tagged up on that fly ball to right, and he's safe at third. One out, first and third. They'll bring up Dalton Maney for Cherokee. Center fielder for Cherokee, number five, Dalton Maney. One out. Hit on the ground out towards second slowly. He fielded, throws. Allen's got him at first, but the run scores from third. So Woodard able to tag up on that fly ball, and he advanced to third base, and that put him where he could score on a ground ball to second, and he did that. So the score's tied now at 1-1. Tara Bradley, the catcher for Cherokee at the plate. Runner on at second and two outs. That's what you call playing small ball. They all count the same. That one run they wiggled around and was able to score by Luke Woodard counts the same as if it had been a home run. Swing and a miss. 1-1. Trevor Bradley, the catcher for Cherokee at the plate. Runner on at second, two outs. Way high, ball two. 2-1 from Darren Blankenship. From the stretch, he checks his runner. Ball gets away, ball three, and the runner will go to third. That's Logan Blankenship. Curtis is running over there for Anaya Yance, the pitcher for Cherokee. He's on at third base with two outs. Ball four. So Terry Bradley walks. That'll bring up Tony Bernheisel, the left fielder for Cherokee. Batting with runners at first and third and two outs. Top of the third. Darren Blankenship still on the mound. Score tied at 1-1. First pitch, ball one. So Blankenship kind of struggled around a little bit this inning after having a real good first and second inning. He'd give up one run already. Runner on at first and third. Swung on, hit down towards shortstop. Bradley fielded it, throws to first, and he got him. So that will retire the side. Cherokee was able to score one run and tied up at 1-1 after in the middle of the third inning. We're tied. Cherokee won, Swain County won. We'll be right back. Okay, leading takes off here in the bottom of the third inning. Will it be center fielder Dylan Smith? He'll be followed by Trey Bradley and Gage Southards. Number 9 batter, Dylan Smith, the center fielder, Philip Smith's son, at the plate. Yeah, still on the mound for Cherokee, winding up and pitching. Strike one is called to Dylan. Tied up 1-1, bottom of the third inning here in Swain County. Swain County and Cherokee. Swung on, hit toward first base. He fields it, takes one step over and stepped on the bag for the out. So just like that, Dylan Smith grounds out to first. That'll turn the batting order over back to the top of the order now. And Trey Bradley at the plate for Swain County. He'll be followed by Gage Southards and Ian Brooks. Trey Bradley at the plate, batting with one out and nobody on. Anai Younce on the mound. Ball one to Bradley. Strike one is called, 1-1, count even. All ones on the scoreboard except the third inning is 1-1 to score, 1-1 to count. Ball two. Two balls and one strike to Trey Bradley, batting with one out and nobody on. Younce from a full windup pitching. Way high, ball two, ball three, 3-1. Three and one to Trey Bradley, batting with one out and nobody on. Bottom of the third. Ball four, he walked him. So with a runner on out first, Gage Southards, the left fielder, comes to the plate. I think Trey Bradley walked his last time up, too. No, he didn't. He's on out first base with one out. Gage Southards at the plate. He squares a bunt and bunts through it. Strike one. Trying to sacrifice here with one out. Put the runner in scoring position, trying to break this 1-1 tie. Throw to first quickly, but he's back safely. Trey Bradley alert on that play. And a good move by Younce, the pitcher. Bradley takes a very short lead, maybe about 3 feet, maybe. Strike is called, 0-2. So he bunted through one and then looked at one for strike two. Gage Southard behind in the count, 0-2. One out and one on. See if they take the bunt play off now. They did, it's ball low, ball one, 1-2. If you bunt one foul with two strikes, you're out. So a lot of times when you get two strikes, you don't want to try to bunt. And he wasn't going to bunt that time. He was going to run back. One ball, two strikes. Ball two. There goes Trey Bradley, second base. So it's late, and he's in safely with a stolen base. So Trey Bradley's on that second. He didn't score in position. That erased the need for that bunt anyway. He's at second base now. And Gage Southern still at the plate. Two balls and two strikes. He could score now on a good base hit to send to the field, outfield. Ball three. Maybe that's ball two. Scoreboard says ball two, 2-2. Yes, pitches. Ball, that was ball four. He walked him. So first and second now. And Ian Brooks comes to the plate, our Swain County's catcher, batting with runners at first and second, still just one out, trying to break a 1-1 tie here in the top of the third inning. Swain County and Cherokee. Freshman Ian Brooks at the plate. Ball one. Yance kind of struggling with his control here. He's walked back-to-back batters. Bradley on the second, Southers at first. Strike one is called to Ian Brooks. 1-1, one out. Yance from the stretch, checks his runners. Ball gets away. There goes Bradley to third. Both runners advance. Second and third now. Ball two to Ian Brooks. Two balls and one strike. Just one out. Two runners in scoring position. Yance from the stretch still. Ball three. 3-1. So Yance just one pitch away from walking the bases full. He's walked two and they're on second and third right now. Got an empty base at first. 3-1 count. Swung on. Hit toward shortstop. Runner's breaking toward the plate. He feels it and throws him out at first. The other runner advances to third. Bradley was able to score from third. Break the tie. 2-1 Swain. So an RBI grounded out by Ian Brooks. That'll bring up the first baseman, Jordan McGaha, batting with a runner on third now and still and two outs. Swain County 2, Cherokee 1. Bottom of the third. Base hit now would get another run in or a pass ball maybe. Yeah, it's throws to third. He wasn't about a foot off of the bag, but he was back safely. That's Gage Southers on at third base. Yance pitches. Swung on. Hit toward shortstop on the ground. He feels it. He throws. He got him. That retires the side. The run does not count. So Jordan McGaha grounds out to short. And that's the end of three innings after three full innings. Our score now, Swain County 2, Cherokee 1. And we'll be right back. Top of the fourth inning now, Swain County on top of Cherokee, 2-1. Darren Blankenship still on the mound for Swain County, pitching a good game. Isaiah Armachain, the third baseman for Cherokee, coming to the plate to lead things off. The number 8 hitter, he'll be followed by Jaden Welch and Jace Waddy. First pitch, hit on the ground towards short. He charges, he fields, Trey Bradley throws him out. Good play, good heads-up play by Trey Bradley. One out. Jaden Welch, now the right fielder for Cherokee, comes to the plate. Batting with one out and nobody on. Darren Blankenship doing a really good job there pitching. He's in the fourth inning, Swain County on top of Cherokee, 2-1. Jaden Welch takes ball one. Blankenship from the stretch, even with nobody on. A swing and a miss. Strike one. 1-1. Jaden Welch, the batter for Cherokee. Blankenship winds and pitches. Fouled off to the right side. Strike two. Dawson Chambers playing third today for Swain. Strike three is called. He struck him out. So Jaden Welch strikes out again. That'll bring up Jace Waddy, Cherokee's best hitter, but it's a good time batting with two outs and nobody on. Blankenship winds and pitches. First pitch hitting in the air out toward right field. It's going to fall in there for a base hit. Michael Laws comes in, picks up on a bounce, and Waddy is on safely at first with a two-out single. So with two outs, Luke Woodard now will be the batter for Cherokee. Blankenship checks the runner. Ball one to Luke Woodard. Luke playing second base today for Cherokee. Blankenship checks the runner. There he goes. He takes off. Throws it down, and he's out. He threw him out trying to steal. Ian Brooks with a rifle throw to second, and he applied the tag, and he's out. That retires a side. So Luke Woodard will be at the plate to start off the fifth inning. After in the middle of the fourth inning, our score remains. Swain County 2, Cherokee 1, and we'll be right back. Okay, Michael Laws will lead things off here in the bottom of the fourth. He'll be followed by Craig Cutshaw and Dawson Chambers. Swain County on top of Cherokee, 2-1, bottom of the fourth inning, close ball game. Younce still on the mound. Anaya Younce done a good job for Cherokee pitching today. Swain County 2, Cherokee 1, bottom of the fourth. Michael Laws at the plate. Teddy Green's nephew. First pitch fouled off to the left side. Strike one. Coach Tyler Shuler made a good play, fielding and throwed it back to the pitcher. Michael Laws takes ball one, 1-1. Anaya Younce, still the pitcher for Cherokee today, done a good job. Laws hits it out toward right center. It's in the right field. Gets by the right fielder. It's going to the wall. Michael Laws on the way to second. And he is standing at second base with a hit and an error, I suppose, on the right fielder. It got by him. He wouldn't have got to second without the ball got by the right fielder. But so that's probably a hit for Michael Laws and an error on the right fielder. That'll bring up Craig Cutshaw to the plate with a run on second and nobody out. Younce from the stretch, ball one to Craig Cutshaw. Michael Laws on at second base, nobody out. Younce from the stretch, checks the runner. Swing and a miss. Strike one, strike two. Strike one, 1-1. One ball and one strike. Younce checks the runner. He throws back behind him, and he's back safely, alertly. Michael Laws is diving back into second base. Jace Waddy applied the tag, which is too little, too late. Younce checks the runner. Way high, ball two. 2-1 out to Craig Cutshaw. On small ball right now, it's very important that you advance that runner to second base, even if to third base, even if you make an out, you got to get the runner over to third. Foul that one off, strike two. You do that by hitting a fly ball to the outfield deep enough to tag him, for him to tag up, or hitting a ground ball to the right side of the infield. If a ball's on the ground in front of that runner, he don't want to go. But if it's behind him, he can advance. Ball three. Got away from the catcher, but not very far. Michael Laws holds at second base. Full count now to Craig Cutshaw. Three balls and two strikes. No outs. Younce checks the runner. Ball four. It hit him. So Michael Laws was on his way to third, but he had to go back since it was hit by pitch. The ball is dead. He cannot advance on a hit batter. So got him at first and second now. And Dawson Chambers to plate, third baseman today for Swain County. Good scoring opportunity. Still nobody out. Swung on. Hit out toward left field. You know, it's in there for a hit. Michael Laws rounds third. He's going to score. Other runners hold it first and second. So Chambers with a good solid hit to left field. Scores a run. 3-1 now, Swain County. That's a big hit by Dawson Chambers. Second baseman Daniel Lammons now comes to the plate for Swain County. Strike one is called to Ammons. Yes, checks the runner. Ball one. Runners at first and second. Still nobody out. Swain County on top now, 3-1. Already scored one run this inning, looking for more. Daniel Ammons, the batter. Yes, checks the runners. Swung on. Hit. We got the bases loaded now. The pitcher got upset about something. He walked off. What? We got the bases loaded and still nobody out. Swain County on top, 3-1. Cherokee's going to change pitchers. That pitcher came off the mound, went into the dugout, threw his glove down. So, yes, didn't like the way things were going, apparently. Whatever, we'll wind this thing out. We'll figure it out, and we'll be right back after the short break. Okay, we're back. Apparently, the Cherokee pitcher had a problem with his finger or something. I'm not sure what it was, but he got it repaired, and he's back out on the mound. That's younger Mr. Younce. Anaya Younce, he's still pitching with the bases still loaded and still nobody out. And now Dylan Smith at the plate for Swain County. Craig Cutshaw takes the lead down third base. Dawson Chambers at second. And Daniel Lammons is at first. Dylan Smith at the plate. Two strikes now to him. 0-2. We'll see if whatever adjustment young Mr. Younce had to make pays off. He fouled that one off. Count holds 0-2. Swain County leading Cherokee 3-1 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Good close ball game. Ball one, 1-2 to Dylan Smith. Playing center field today for Swain County. Big slow curve is floats outside. Ball two. 2-2. Strike three is called. So Dylan Smith is called out on strikes with the bases loaded and nobody outs. That'll bring us back to the top of the batting order. Young Mr. Trey Bradley at plate now with the bases still loaded. Big scoring opportunity now for Swain County. Had a big strike out of Smith, but Younce, whatever adjustment he made, it worked. Trey Bradley now at the plate, Swain's leading hitter on the year. Ball gets away. Runner Craig Cutshaw trying to score, and he is standing up. He scored on a wild pitch. The other runners advanced to second and third, Chambers and Ammons. Makes the score now 4-1. Swain County on top of Cherokee. One out, two men on. Trey Bradley at the plate. 1-0 the count. Swung on. Hit down towards shortstop. It's out in left field for a hit. One run scores. Here comes a second run. Ammons, he's going to stand up. He scores. So a two-run single, but Trey Bradley brings it to 6-1 now in the bottom of the fourth inning. Is big clutch hit by Trey Bradley, two runs scoring. He's on at first base with still just one out, and Gage Suther's now coming to the plate, left fielder for Swain County. And I younce on the mound. High ball one to Gage. One and oh. Ball two. Yance from the stretch. Ball three. That goes the runner. Trying to steal second. He's in there easily. Trey Bradley timed that just exactly right, and he slid, but he didn't have to. He was in by a wide margin at safely at second base. Swain County leading Cherokee 6-1 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. 3-0 the count to Gage Southers. Strike one is the call. 3-1 now. Trey Bradley on second base and one out. Yance checks him. Swung on, grounded out in front of the pitcher, feels it, and he throws the third in to get the run there, and he throws it away. And Trey Bradley will score, and Gage Southers goes to second. So the wheels are flying off for Cherokee right now. Nothing going right for him. And here comes Gage Southers to third with nobody covering it. He's out. There's a foot race to the bag, and Gage Southers didn't win. Something called him out. Tyler Shooter looked like he was safe, but he's going to appeal to the home plate umpire, see if he had a better view of it. They both were running to third base, and Gage Southers looked like he got in safely, but the umpire was right on top of it, and he called him out. Tyler Shuler is coaching right there, right on top of it, too, and he didn't like it. And so he's appealing that call to the home plate umpire to see if he had a better view of it. He's out. So Gage Southers is out. So that's the second out of the inning. 7-1 now is the score. Two outs and nobody on. Ian Brooks at the plate. Yeah, it's from a full windup now. Way high, ball one to Ian Brooks. Looked like Gage Southers thought he had an angle. He thought there was nobody on covering third base. The third baseman had come over here to retrieve that wild throw, and he thought nobody was covering third base, so he thought he would probably come in there pretty easily. But the third baseman was pretty quick. He got the ball, and he beat him to the bag. Granted, in the hole, a short. Let's see if he got him. No, he had no way. Ian Brooks beat that with plenty of time, so he's on it. First was a base hit. The ball got away and it hung in the fence over there, so Ian Brooks is awarded second base. I guess that's a ground rule. It was a wild throw, and he went over and got hung in the fence. So he walks into second. He's there now with two outs, and Jordan McGaugh has a batter. 7-1 to score. Swain County on top, bottom of the fourth. Yance still on the mound. And now Yance pitching for Cherokee. Ball one to Jordan McGaugh, a big first baseman for Swain County. Ian Brooks on the second. I guess you'd call that a hit and an error. He got a hit. He's on it first, but went to second on the error. Go back to second. He's barely back in, diving. Good pickoff move by Anaya Yance. I think that's Luke Woodard coming over covering the bag. But Brooks is back in safely. 1-0 the count. Ball two. There goes Brooks to third. He's safely. Ball goes in third in left field. He's going to score standing up. So the base running skills of Ian Brooks and the throwing errors for Cherokee allowed him to come all the way around. 8-1 now. Swain County on top. Jordan McGaugh batting now with two outs and nobody on. High, ball three. Now, scoreboard says ball two. Maybe that's ball two. I lost count. Strike one is called. An eye out on the mound for Cherokee. Swung and foul back. Strike two. It's a full count. 3 balls and 2 strikes. 2 outs and nobody on. And now Yance winding and pitching. Swung on. Hitting the air to second. Second baseman going back in the short left right field. He can't get it. It drops in. So that's an error on the second baseman. He should have had that. He popped it up right behind second, and he missed it. So McGay has safely on it first. Nevertheless, on the E4, and Michael Laws comes to the plate. Batting with 2 outs and now and a runner on first. Michael Laws takes ball one. Fouled in the air by first. First baseman's over in foul territory, falling down, and he makes the catch. So a good play by the first baseman for Cherokee on that pop-up by Michael Laws, and that will retire the side. After four full innings, our score now is Swain County 8, Cherokee 1, and we'll be right back. Okay, leading off for Cherokee in the top of the fifth inning will be Luke Woodard, followed by Nye Younce and Demetrius Bradley. Trailing Swain County 8-1. Swain County on top. Top of the fifth inning. Darren Blankenship still on the mound for Swain County. He's went all the way. Done a good job. Strike one is called to Luke Woodard. Bradley from the stretch. Swung on. Foul back. Strike two. 0-2 the count now to Luke Woodard. Swain County scored 7 runs that last inning to jump out on top 8-1. Strike three, Luke Woodard, weak swing. So 1 out and a 9 ounce. The opposing pitcher now comes up for Cherokee. An eye ounce, number 12. Ball one. Inside. Look like it might have hit him, but it didn't. He barely got out of the way. 1-0. Strike one is called. 1-1. Darren Blankenship, no runners on. Another weak swing, strike two to Younce. So Darren Blankenship done a good job keeping all off balance, changing speeds. And strike three is called, so struck him out. 2 strikeouts in a row. That'll bring up the cleanup man, Demetrius Bradley, first baseman for Cherokee, batting with 2 outs and nobody on. Top of the fifth inning, 8-1 to score. Swain County on top. Darren Blankenship has pitched the whole ball game for Swain County, done a really good job. Swing and a miss by Bradley. Big left-handed batter. He made a good play that last inning on that pop-up. He fell down over next to the dugout, but he came up with it. Good play. Ball one, 1-1. Blankenship, swing and a miss, big swing and a miss, strike two. Well, Top of the fifth inning. Swain County 8, Cherokee 1. High ball 2. Count even at 2-2. Demetrius Bradley, the batter. Swinging a foul, just barely got a piece of it, fouled it back. Count holds, 2-2. Two outs. Darren Blankenship back up on the mound. Top of the fifth inning. Swain County and Cherokee. Swain County on top, 8-1. Blankenship from the stretch pitching. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. So Demetrius Bradley strikes out. And that'll retire the side at the end of 4 1/2 innings. Our score, Swain County 8, Cherokee 1. And we'll be right back. Okay, we've got a new pitcher on the mound now for Cherokee as Jace Waddy comes in from shortstop to take over for Younce on the mound. Jace Waddy will be the new pitcher for Cherokee. He'll be facing Cody Danner leading things off. Takes strike one. Danner is batting for Craig Cutshaw. Swung on, hit in the air. Down on the ground, out of the second base. He feels it, he throws the first, and Danner is retired for the first out. That'll bring up Dawson Chambers. The third baseman today for Swain County, Dawson Chambers. He got a big hit a while ago. Jace Waddy, strike one to Chambers. Batting with one out and nobody on. Waddy pitches, hit on the ground to second. Second baseman fields it, throws to first, and he got him. So two up and two down quickly for Swain County. That'll bring up Daniel Ammons for Swain County, the second baseman today. Batting with two outs and nobody on. Swain County on top of Cherokee, 8-1 in the bottom of the fifth inning. Ammons at the plate. Takes it way high, ball one. Jace Waddy on the mound for Cherokee. Strike is called, 1-1. Daniel Ammons the batter. Jace Waddy the pitcher, way high again, ball 2-1. Bottom of the fifth, 8-1 Swain. Jace Waddy winding and pitching. Swing and a miss. Strike 2-2. Jace Waddy, winding and pitching to Ammons. Swing and a miss, he struck him out. So that will retire the side, 3 up and 3 down to Jace Waddy. After 5 full innings, our score remains, Swain County 8, Cherokee 1, and we'll be right back. Okay, Dalton Maney leading off for Cherokee here in the top of the sixth. Dalton Maney. First pitch, hit back to the pitcher. He knocks it down, thumbs around and picks it up and throws, and he got him. So one pitch and one out for Dalton Maney. He'll be followed by Tur Bradley and Tony Bernheisel. Tur Bradley is the catcher today for Cherokee. Dons those tools of ignorance and gets behind the plate every half inning. Thankless job, but it's very important. Tur Bradley does a good job with it for Cherokee, as does Ian Brooks for Swain. Swing and a miss, strike one. Darren Blankenship has pitched the whole ball game here. We're on the sixth inning and 8-1 Cherokee. He done a good job. Darren Blankenship still on the mound. Outside, ball one, 1-1. Sonia Blankenship's son. Strike one, two, swing and a miss. Darren Blankenship on the mound. Low and outside, ball two. Count even now, 2-2. Batting with one out and nobody on in the top of the sixth. Swain County 8, Cherokee 1. Darren Blankenship from the stretch, even with nobody on, he still pitches from the stretch all the time. Swing and a miss. Strike three, he struck him out. So two outs now. And Tony Bernheisel, the left fielder, now comes to bat for Cherokee. Bernheisel to plate batting with two outs and nobody on. Take strike one from Blankenship. From the stretch, all night long. Foul back, strike two, quickly to Bernheisel. Bottom of the sixth, Swain County trying to break a three-game losing streak. Strike three is called as Bernheisel's out on strikes. So just like that, three up, three down here in the sixth inning as Blankenship is rolling on. Bottom of the sixth coming up, Swain County 8, Cherokee 1, and we'll be right back. Okay, Dylan Smith leading things off here from the bottom of the sixth for Swain County, leading Cherokee 8-1. Jace Watt is still on the mound for Cherokee. Came on in relief of Younts the inning before and did a good job, three up and three down. So Dylan Smith, center fielder for Swain County, leading it off. Takes it in the dirt, ball one. That's Philip Smith's son, Dylan Smith, at the plate. Playing center field today for Swain County. Fouled off. Strike one, 1-1. Waddy winds and pitches. Swung on. Hit on the ground to second. Second baseman feels it and throws him out. So one up and one out. They'll turn it over to the top of the batting order again. Trey Bradley coming up for Swain County. Against Jace Waddy. Waddy has done a really good job. He's retired 4 men in a row since he come on. Trey Bradley, Swain's shortstop. And leadoff batter, leading hitter for the year at the plate. Takes ball one high from Waddy. Swain County 8, Cherokee 1. Bottom of the sixth. Fouled off, strike one. Trey Bradley, the batter. That's Dean Bradley's grandson. Waddy winds and pitches. High. In the dirt, ball three. I believe it is 3-1. Scoreboard went off. Now it's back on. Trey Bradley batting with one out and nobody on base against Jace Waddy. Track two is called. Full count. Waddy winds and pitches. Swung on. Hit in the air out behind second. Luke Woodard is back. He makes the catch in short right field. Luke Woodard, good play. Two outs. And we've got a pinch hitter. That's Brady Kirkland now coming up for Swain County in the place of Gage Southards. Brady Kirkland, number 16. First pitch hits it foul down the right field line. Strike one. Brady Kirkland, the pinch hitter. Waddy winding and pitching. Swing and a miss, strike two. Two outs and nobody on. Bottom of the sixth inning. Swing County on top of Cherokee, 8-1. Swung on. Hit in the right field for a hit. Gets by the right fielder. Kirkland's around first. He's on his way to second. Right fielder finally picks it up. He throws it in, and Kirkland is standing at second base on a hit and an error. He had a clean base hit, but it got by the right fielder, and he got the second base on it. So Brady Kirkland is in scoring position with two outs here in the bottom of the sixth. Ian Brooks comes to the plate, our catcher, and just a freshman. Running scoring position, that's Brady Kirkland on at second base. Jace Waddy steps back, and nobody covering second, but the runner got back. Waddy from the stretch looks the runner back. Pitches to Brooks, ball one. Swain County 8, Cherokee 1, bottom of the sixth. Run on second and two outs. Low, ball two. 2-0 to Ian Brooks. That hit him. So Ian Brooks hit by pitch. He didn't like that either. I think that hurt. But he's going to first. He's at first. Kirkland's at second. And Jordan McGahey, the first baseman for Swain, comes to the plate. Swain County with a 7-run lead, 8-1. Two runners on, and big Jordan McGahey at the plate. If he get one out right now, it'd be over. It'd be a 10-run lead. I'm sure he's got that on his mind, too, as he took a big swing and fouled that one off. Strike one. Jordan McGahey, Swain County's first baseman to play, batting with runners at first and second and two outs. Oh, he hit him. He didn't like that either. He throws his bat up in the air. Umpire warns him, says, no more flipping the bat. That's two hit batters in a row by Jace Waddy. That'll bring up Michael Laws now, batting with the bases loaded and two outs. Bottom of the sixth inning, Swain County on top 8-1. Michael Laws the batter. Big swing and a miss. He's going for the downs there, I could tell. He's done it before. He's ended the ball game with a grand slam home run. That'd be nice to do that again. Swung on. Hit on the ground, held short. It's fumbled, and he has no play. He has to eat it. One run will score, and the bases remain loaded. It hit it in the hole. I think it should be called a base hit. I don't know, but the shortstop fumbled it, but I don't think it got him anyway. 9-1 now, the score. Cody Danner, the batter for Swain County. He batted last time for Craig Cutshaw, and he's still in the lineup for him. Cody Danner, the designated hitter. Count evens now, 1-1. Jace Waddy, full windup pitches. Swing and a miss, strike two to Cody Danner. Cody's a senior this year. Somebody called time, but I don't know who. I heard it. It said time. Ball. Count even 2-2 to Cody Danner. Batting in the bottom of the sixth. Swain County 9, Cherokee 1. Bases loaded, two outs. Ball 3. Nowhere to put him. The bases are loaded. Full count. Bases, everybody will be running on the pitch. Full count, two outs. Strike 3 is called. So Cody Danner strikes out looking. And that'll end the inning. After 6 full innings, our score now is Swain County 9, Cherokee 1, and we'll be back momentarily. Okay, here we go. Top of the 7th. This is it. Swain County 9, Cherokee 1. Due up for Cherokee will be Isaiah Armitain, Jaden Welch, and the top of the order, Jace Waddy. So third baseman Isaiah Armitain leading things off here for Cherokee in the top of the 7th. Darren Blankenship still on the mound. He's pitched the whole ball game. Strike one to Armitain. Blankenship has done a tremendous job here today. Swung on, foul back, 0-2. Blankenship got the sign, pitches, ball one low. This is what the doctor ordered for Swain County on a 3-game losing streak. And Darren Blankenship comes through when we needed him the most. Ball 2-2. Need three more outs. Isaiah Armitain, the batter, third baseman for Cherokee. Strike 3 is called. That's one of them. So Armitain is out looking. That'll bring up number 9 hitter, Jaden Welch, right fielder for Cherokee. No, we got a pinch hitter. That's 19. That's Chase Andrews, the pinch hitter for Cherokee. Chase Andrews, I know him. I like Chase. I went to church with him for a long time. He's a nice guy. Chase Andrews at the plate, batting with one out and one on. Strike one is called. Darren Blankenship on the mound, batting, pitching. He's pitched 6 1/3. Swing and a miss by Chase Andrews. Strike two. Darren Blankenship got the sign, pitching with a stretch to Chase Andrews. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. So Chase Andrews goes down swinging. We got two outs and nobody on. One more out. And leadoff man Jace Waddy, the opposing pitcher, comes to the plate for Cherokee. You never want to make the last out. And I know Jace Waddy does not want to make the last out. He takes low ball one from Darren Blankenship. You could tell that last inning, Jace Waddy is quite a competitor. He's swinging a miss, struck one. He's Cherokee's leading hitter on the year. Strike two is called. So Darren Blankenship is not letting up at all. I mean, he's been tremendous all day long. 1-2 is a count to Waddy. Swung on, hit, foul. Count holds at 1-2. One and two, two outs, nobody on. 9-1 the score, Swain County on top. hit in the air out behind second. Second baseman Ammons goes back, and he makes the catch. So just like that, that's it. That's the third out, three up and three down in the seventh inning. Darren Blankenship, everybody pit, played a good ball game. Our final score today, Swain County 9, Cherokee 1. And we're going to wrap things up, and we'll see you later. Have a good day.